بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والصلاة والسلام على أفضل الأنبياء والمرسلين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين. صلى الله عليك يا أبا عبد الله، صلى الله عليك يا ابن رسول الله، صلى الله عليك يا مسلوب العمامة والرضا، يا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله، عظم الله لك الأجر بمصاب أختك زينب الكبرى، عظم الله لك الأجر يا مولاي يا صاحب الأمر بهذا المصاب، وعظم الله لكم الأجر جميعا. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد، عجل فرجهم ولعن أعداءهم. My dearest brothers and sisters in Islam, the attending angels in this majlis, I salute you with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And I begin by sending my condolences to Sahib al-Amr, arwahuna li turabi maqdamihi al-fida, on this tragic occasion that marks the passing, nay, the martyrdom of Sayyida Zainab, alayha afdalu salati wa atamma salam. And I also send my condolences to the maraji', to the scholars, to the attendees, to all of creation on the martyrdom of this sacred lady, Aqilatu Bani Hashim, Zainab al-Kubra. We begin with these words from Surah Al-Baqarah. Verse 282, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, واتقوا الله ويعلمكم الله والله بكل شيء عليم. صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسوله الكريم. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. زينب وما أدراك ما زينب. زينب, and what do you truly know of Zainab? What does humanity truly know of the lady that is known as Zainab al-Kubra? Alayha afdalu salati wa atamma al-taslim. Zainab, the daughter of Ali and Fatima, peace be upon them. Zainab, the granddaughter of Umm al-Mu'mineen Khadija, alayhi salam, and of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Where does one begin? And this is the question. Where does one begin when he or she wishes to speak about Zainab? روحي لها الفداء. May my soul and my existence be ransomed for Zainab. الحديث بذكر زينب ذو شجون. The hadith of Zainab, when speaking about Zainab, is a never-ending topic. Upon beginning this topic, you keep on taking routes, different routes, because when you begin to talk about Zainab, what do you speak about? Do you speak about the Masa'ib of Zainab? Do you speak about the ilm of Zainab? Do you speak about the high status and grandeur and status that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given Zainab? The status that unfortunately is overlooked by both the khasata and the amma. The khasa and amma overlook the status and maqam of Zainab. Because even amongst the khasa, amongst the Shia themselves, unfortunately speaking, there is taqseer when it comes to Zainab. Zainab alayhi salam was born. Zainab alayhi salam was born in the house of revelation. And by the house of revelation here, we mean the house of Fatima. As you know, Baytu Fatima, this ibarah here, this structure, this phrase where you hear these two words, Baytu Fatima, the house of Fatima, this sentence right here, this phrase, whatever you may call it, is found throughout the hadith. Because Baytu Fatima was the source where every Muslim during that time used to go to that house of Fatima in order to seek Ali, to seek Fatima alayhi salam, and learn Ma'alim al-Din, learn the religion and all that revolves around the religion. Baytu Fatima, that house that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, every time he would leave for travels and come back from travels, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi would come to that house. That's where Zainab alayhi salam was raised. Her sister Ummu Kalthum, Al-Hasanan, Al-Hasan, Al-Husayn. Because it goes Hasan, Husayn, Zainab, Ummu Kalthum, and then Al-Muhassin, Al-Shaheed, the martyr, the unborn child. Those were the children of Fatima alayhi salam. And of course, raised in that house of revelation, one develops character, one develops outstanding character, outstanding khisal. Not just character, but outstanding khisal, outstanding characteristics. Because when you're raised by Rasulullah, when you are taught knowledge by Rasulullah, you reach a maqam in which that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins to teach you. Taqwa and knowledge are two things that work hand in hand. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we read in Surah Al-Baqarah, if you have taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yu'allim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches the individual has taqwa. Zainab kanat qimmat al-taqwa. Walihada qad allamaha Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Walihada qad qala Ali ibn al-Husayn alayhi salam. Kama rawahu al-Tabrasi fi kitab al-Ihtijaj. Ya ammah. أنت بحمد الله عالمة غير محلمة وفهمة غير مفهمة. When you have taqwa and you are taught by Allah, then you read what Ali ibn al-Husayn alayhi salam states in the Majlis of Yazid during the end of the sermon of Zainab Ali ibn al-Husayn, as reported in Al-Ihtijaj by our Shaykh At-Tabrasi radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhi, says, Auntie Zainab, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anti alima, you are a scholar. You are a learned scholar. You are one who was taught not by man, you are one who was taught by Allah. And then he says, and one who has comprehended and understood غير مفهمة. Nobody made you, nobody taught you, nobody gave you the way to understand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was the one who guides you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who pushes you, who provides you with the pathway towards knowledge and towards the attainment of knowledge. That is Zainab. Zainab! And by the way, we will refer to this hadith later on when we shed light upon the proofs that make Zainab alayhi salam have an ismah of some sort, an infallibility of some sort. There is an infallibility toward, that's why I say there are shortcomings when it comes to Zainab alayhi salam. Zainab is overlooked by the khasa and the amma. Leave the amma aside. Our focus is on the Shia themselves. Zainab is overlooked. Her maqam is reduced to just a lady, a normal lady. From the household of Muhammad, sometimes you find people speaking about her in this matter. Unfortunately, we will find that Zainab possesses an infallibility. Yes, this infallibility is different. This isma ليس كعصمة النبي الأكرم وفاطمة عليها السلام والأئمة الأطهار. This عصمة, this infallibility is not like the عصمة of the prophets of Fatima and of who? Of the Imams, peace be upon them, the 14 معصومين. It's a different عصمة. And there are, كما تعلم, عدة إصطلاحات لهذه العصمة. يعني أكو بعض الناس يسمونها بالعصمة الصغرى وبعض الناس يسمونها بالعصمة الإفعالية العصمة الفعلية وبعض الناس كشيخنا السند المرجع اللي معاصر الآن في النجف الأكرم في النجف الأشرف عفوا يسميها الدائرة الاصطفائية الثانية. So we will find that infallibility has many definitions. This secondary infallibility, this infallibility that Zainab alayhi salam possesses. This infallibility is sometimes referred to as I was speaking right now, explaining to some of the brothers in Arabic. Sometimes it's called the minor isma, as-sughra. Sometimes it's called as the ismatul if'aliyya or fi'aliyya. The infallibility that comes from the actions and the abstainment of an individual, the individual that is guided in a way where he or she abstains from certain sinful acts. And we'll get into more detail. One of the writers who has a book on Ismat Sayyidah Zainab, I think his name is Ali, I believe, Ali Hadi. I'll check later, inshallah. We'll look at it later. But he talks about this asmat, and that's what he calls it. And then there's a second, there's a third mustalah that Shaykh As-Sanad, hafadhuullah, speaks about, which is the da'ira istafa'iyya, the secondary infallible circle that revolves around the primary infallible circle. We'll get into that in detail, inshallah. Back to Zainab alayhi salam. A little bit of light on how Zainab alayhi salam is treated. And just by looking at the books of hadith, by the way, just to show you how grand Zainab alayhi salam is in the eyes of the Muslims themselves as well, during that time as well. For example, when you refer to the books of Rijal, did you know that Zainab alayhi salam rawiyah lil hadith, قد روت الحديث عن أمها وأخيها الحسن والحسين وعن أبيها علي بن أبي طالب وعن جدها. So when you look back at the books of Rijal, you will discover that Zainab عليه السلام transmitted hadith from her mother. For example, Zainab عليه السلام is the one who shares with us خطبة الفدكية الخطبة الفاطمية. The Fadak sermon is narrated by Zainab alayhi salam. In other ahadith we have narrated by Zainab alayhi salam. She's a narrator of hadith. She's a muhaddatha herself. She narrates as well as narrates from others. And that is why Ibn Abbas, it is said, when Ibn Abbas introduces Zainab, he says, حَدَّثَتْنَا عَقِيلَةُ بَنِي هَاشِمْ. When he refers to Zainab, he did not say, وَقَالَتْ زَيْنَبُ بِنْتُ عَلِي. No, he said, وَحَدَّثَتْنَا عَقِيلَةُ بَنِي هَاشِمْ. هذا الفخر لزينب. This grandeur for Zainab. When Ibn Abbas speaks about Zainab, this is how he narrates from Zainab. And the question is now, what does Aqila mean? We refer to a couple of what some of the linguists say and some of the scholars say. Ibn Manzur in Lisan al-Arab, he says, وَالْعَقِيلَةَ عَقِيلَةُ الْقَوْمِ سَيِّدُهُمْ وَعَقِيلَةُ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْرَمَهُ. He says, the aqila of every group of people or of peoples is their master. So in this case, when we say aqila to Bani Hashim, we say the mistress and the master of Banu Hashim, Zainab al-Kubra. That's what Ibn Abbas, when he is praising Zainab in that matter. And then he, وَعَقِيلَةُ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ أَكْرَمُهُ. And the aqila of everything is what is the most honorable of that thing. Akramu, the most generous, the most honorable, is considered aqila. So we say that Zainab alayhi salam is the master, the mistress, the lady of Bani Hashim, and the most honorable and generous of Banu Hashim. If Abbas alayhi salam is the moon of Bani Hashim, Zainab is the haqila of Bani Hashim, and through the light and illumination of Abbas, Zainab alayhi salam finds her way. Now what happens then when the moon is extinguished and the light disappears? And that is why after Abbas, Zainab was lost, and she knew that Karbala has come to an end. After Abbas, there was no Karbala. Hussein knew it, and Zainab knew it. When that illumination from the Nur of Abbas is extinguished, then Zainab alayhi salam knew Aqila to Bani Hashim. Abu Faraj al-Asfahani, in his book Maqatil al-Talibin, says, وَيُقَالْ زَيْنَبُ الْعَقِيلَةِ أَيْ عَقِيلَةُ بَنِي هَاشِمْ وهي التي روى ابن عباس عنها كلام فاطمة عليها السلام في فدك فقال حدثتني عقيلة زينب عقيلتنا زينب بنت علي. أبو فرج says, الأصفهاني, he says, and Zainab عليه السلام, who is referred to as العقيلة, and she is the one whom Ibn Abbas reports the what? The incident at Fadak from her, and he says, وَحَدَّثَتْنِي عَقِيلَتُنَا زَيْنَبْ. He says that when Ibn Abbas reports, this is very important, the way Ibn Abbas speaks about Zainab. When Ibn Abbas is reporting from Zainab the incident of Fadak, and our aqila, our lady, our mistress, our master, Zainab reports. That is just shedding the light, by the way, upon Zainab. Zainab, by the way, Zainab alayhi salam, did you also know? We know her birth and upbringing, of course. There's no need to go into that. Her name, her sacred name, her sacred name that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose. Let's read the incident of the birth of Zainab. As you know, Hassan was born, Hussein was born. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran, Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad wa ajjil farajuhum wa la'an a'da'uhum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, when he speaks about the birth of the mother, حَمَلَتُ أُمُّهُ إِلَىٰ أَخْرِ الْآيَةِ, and his mother bore him with detesting it, and then also brought him with detest. Because as you know, the mother goes through كرهن, right? The mother goes through immense pain through childbirth. But the pain that Zahra Fatima alayhi salam underwent was a pain unlike any other, because Fatima alayhi salam would speak to her womb, to her child. Al-Hasan would speak to her, and she would be informed of the ghaybiyat, the unseen matters that were going to unfold upon Al-Hasan and Hussein. After that, when she had Zainab alayhi salam, when she was pregnant with Zainab alayhi salam, she knew that a time will come when the Prophet will inform her of what happened to Zainab. Now imagine Fatima alayhi salam bringing forth into this world a child, a girl, and then there he is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. It says, Ya Ibnati, Ya Fatima. After Rasulullah takes Zainab alayhi salam and he brings her towards his chest, and he begins to speak to Zainab. He begins to weep, he begins to cry. وَضَمَّهَا إِلَىٰ صَدْرِ. He begins to cry, and then Fatima says to him, Ya Abata, لِمَاذَا تَبْكِي. He says, Ya Fatima, إِنَّ هَذِهِ الْبِنْتِ سَتُبْلَى بِبَلَايَا وَتُرْدْ عَلَيْهَا مَصَائِبٌ شَتَّى وَرَزَايَا أَدْهَا. Hi, Umm al-Masa'ib. He says that Zainab will undergo tragedy, pain and suffering, one more sour and worse than the other. And then the hadith goes on, and then the Imam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, says, and by the way, we thank all those who cry upon Zainab. Wallah, lakum al-ajr al-baakuna ala Zainab. Asma' maada qala Rasulullah, ya bad'ati wa qurrata ayni. Inna man baka alayha wa ala masaibha yakunu thawabahu ka thawab man baka ala akhawayha thumma sammaha Zainab. He says, Ya Fatima, and whoever weeps upon Zainab is like he who has wept upon Hassan and Hussein, her brothers, and for them is a grand reward. And then he named her Zainab, salawatullahi alayha, wa ruhi laha al-fida. Now, a short shedding of light upon the name Zainab. Now, for the name Zainab, there's more than one definition of to the origin of the name itself. We have, for example, the first of these, which is reported by Al-Firuzabadi in his Qamus. Al-Firuzabadi in his Qamus, in his dictionary, narrates, he says, Zainab kalimatun murakkaba min zainin wa ab. Says that Zainab, the word Zainab, is a composite, a complex word. A word that is comprised of Zayn and Ab, ornament, decoration, and father. Meaning what? The ornament or the decoration of her father. And truly, Zainab alayhi salam was Zainu Abiha Ali ibn Abi Talib. The same way that her mother Fatima was Ummu Abiha. The characteristics of Zainab alayhi salam and her mother Fatima, by the way, يعني, are very alike. Like what Zainab alayhi salam did is almost exactly like what her mother Fatima alayhi salam did. If you look at what Fatima alayhi salam did, by the way, which nobody from the Imams did, for example, عندما وقفت إمام الطاغية ابن أبي قحافة وخطبت خطبتها الفدكية الفاطمية, when Zainab alayhi salam stood in front of that majlis, in front of an individual, a tyrant like Abu Bakr, who was a man who was known to spill blood, a man who was known to be ferocious. She stood in front of all these men. Fatima alayhi salam alone stood. What did she do? She stood in front of all of these men, and she was able to group an entire army, Ma'askar al-Zahra, ضد الطاغية. وأعطت فتواها قاتلوا أئمة الكفر. Fatima alayhi salam. Fatima, in a matter of moments, was able to get an entire army against Abu Bakr. They had to stop her. What happened now? Look at Zainab alayhi salam. The same way Zainab alayhi salam stood in front of Yazid and Ubaidullah and so on and so forth. All of them. Zainab alayhi salam stood in front of them and she did the same thing, to the point where the tyrant al-Taghiyah had to cut her off. He had to cut her off the same way he had to cut off Ali ibn al-Husayn with the adhan. Zainab and Fatima was able to do that. And that's why, by the way, min asrar khuruj Zainab min al-Madina ila al-Sham, li'annaha kanat tuharriku an-nas dhidd al-Tughat. فما قدر يزيد وغيره وذولاك الأشباه أن ماذا أن يحتملوا هذا الأمر. زينب عليه السلام was able to do this through Hussein عليه السلام and his sacrifice. She was able to move the people in a way unlike any other. And that's why, by the way, for those who look down about الشعائر أبا عبد الله, زينب عليه السلام, by the way, is مؤسسة الشعائر. Just to let you know, Zainab Ali is the founder of Sha'ar. It's through her Sha'ar she was able to move mountains. Ruhi laha al-fida. The second definition of Zainab is what Ibn Manzur al-Lisan al-Arab says. He says, Ibn Manzur al-Lisan al-Arab, Zainab kalimatun basita wa laysat murakkaba wa hiya ismun shajaratin aw amwarta. Zainab, in fact, he says here that Zainab is not a complex word, it's a simple word which either means flower or rose. That's the word Zainab. And as you know, from the kuna of Zainab alayhi salam is Ummu Kalthum, or also there are some reports say that also from her kuna is Ummu al-Hasan as well. There are some reports that say that. And by the way, Ummu Kalthum, Zainab and Ummu Kalthum, and also her sister is called Ummu Kalthum as well. So that's why sometimes there could be mistakes between the two as to who is the older of the two. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
So to almost come to near the conclusion, near the end, because we don't want to take too much of your time. There is more information, of course, but we want to focus on the maqamat and the fada'il of Zainab alayhi salam. We said in the introduction that Zainab alayhi salam possesses what you may refer to as, like I said, the a'lam refer to this asma, right? The asma of Zainab, of Al-Abbas alayhi salam, of Al-Qasim, Fatima al-Ma'suma, and others. There's, you can say there currently there are about three definitions that I have myself have come across when it comes to the asma of these individuals, these sacred individuals. We said some ulama referred to it as al-asma al-sughra, the minor infallibility. Adil al-Alawi. He has a book. He has lectures, muhadarat, which were transcribed into a book. So he refers to the asma of Sayyidah Zainab alayhi salam as al-asmatul al-fi'liyatul aliyah, which you can translate to as the infallibility of action and execution. And he says that this asma, a lam yartakabu al-dhanb fi af'alihim min hina wuladatihim wa hatta hina wafatihim. Fa'asmatuhum hadhi tusamma bil'ismatul if'aliyya wa fi'liyya aw al-kasbiyya wa innaha al-juz'iyya wa laysa ismatun dhatiyya fala tajib alayhim aqlan. Li'anna al-ismatu al-dhatiyya mukhtassatun bil'anbiya'i wa la'immata wa fatimata alayhum as-salam. So he says that this asma is asma in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or through kasbiyya, meaning they could have attained it through the way that they were taught. It's basically the infallibility of action and execution, that individual has reached such a high status in the eyes of Allah. And Allah has also taught them. Allah has also revealed, as we said in Surah Al-Baqarah, اتقوا الله ويعلمكم الله الوحي. يعلمكم الله. Not in the sense that an angel sends upon you, but Allah reveals to you. اتقوا الله ويعلمكم الله. Surah Al-Baqarah, we said 268, I believe, if memory serves me correctly. That some individuals have reached this knowledge to the point where when they see the makruh, the najasa, when they see that fi'l al-qabih, that sin, they see that فعل بصورته الحقيقية and they abstain from it through knowledge and through their أفعال, through their actions. And of course he goes on into detail and he gives evidence, and then he begins to say that it begins with عدالة, then after عدالة you have this أصمة. He goes into very, we don't have that much time, that's the thing, we don't have that much time. But and then there's also the other asma, except asma al-sughra, which also is derived from narrations. But in my view, the closest definition to the asma that Zainab alayhi salam has is the one that Sheikh Muhammad al-Sanad in his various lectures, and also in this book, it's a four-volume book called Al-Da'irat al-Istafa'iyyat al-Thaniya li Abi Fadl al-Abbasi alayhi salam. That's the exact title of the book. In which he states, he doesn't talk about the infallibility of Zainab and Abbas and these other characters in the sense that it is the same as this, either kasbiya or fa'liya, that it is attained through other means or is attained through their actions and through them abstaining from certain manners. Because he also states, for example, that hatta al-marja' taqlid, for example, has a some marja', right? We have some of the conditions of them, they have to be adil, they have to be just, for example. You know, they can't perform kaba'ir, you know, big major sins, and even some of them don't perform minor sins. So our question now is, when you refer to it as isma sughra, when you refer to it as isma fi'liya, or any other definition, and you refer to that as Zainab alayhi salam or Abbas alayhi salam possesses this isma, the question is, how do you then begin to differ between the likes of Fadl al-Abbas and Zainab and the likes of the marja' taqlid? حفظهم الله, the عدول and the just ones, may Allah protect them. We're not saying anything, but we're saying, how do you then begin to distinguish? Which is why Sheikh al-Sanad in his lectures, in his books, he bases this off Quran and Hadith, and he proves that the 14 ma'soom, the 14 infallibles, they are asma khasa lahum. Nobody shares anything but them in this asma. Then he says, around these 14 ma'soomin, there is a secondary circle, a da'irah. Istafa'iyya as well, meaning what? Istafa meaning appointmentship and from Allah. So Allah is the one who chooses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yastafi hadha shakhs. Through the test that they received before in alam al-dhar, in the universe before this, in the atoms and protons. So he says to them, he says that this da'irah, according to the traditions of the Ahlul Bayt, for example, and according to the Quran al-Kareem, you find that there is a secondary circle. There is a secondary circle that revolves around the primary circle. And the likes of Zainab alayhi salam, al-Abbas alayhi salam, al-Qasim, Fatima al-Ma'asuma, Ali al-Akbar, wal-Azghar, they are in this da'ira. And then there's many evidences, of course. We're going to look at some of the evidences, inshallah. But as a quick summarization, refer to the hadith, for example, of Fatima al-Ma'asuma alayhi salam, in which a group of the Shia came from where? They came to ask Al-Kadhim alayhi salam questions. Al-Kadhim alayhi salam wasn't at home. They came, they knocked the door. Ayna abuki, ayna al-Kadhim? Fi safarin. He was traveling. She then sat down at Fatima al-Ma'asuma bint al-Imam Musa and answered every single question. And look, we're not done yet, because he was, okay, what does that mean? Okay, she answered every question. Okay. After that, when Imam al-Kadhim was told, ibnatuka qalat kada wa kada wa kada wa kada wa ajabat kada wa kada, qala qad hakamat bi hukm Allah. Qad hakamat bi hukm Allah. That's all he said. Madmun al-Hadith. When they told him, your daughter Fatima said such and such and such and such, and she answered such and such, he said, Fatima alayhi salam has judged and has given the hukum, the verdict of Allah, Fatima al-Ma'asuma. That alone, at the end of the day, at least it leaves you to ponder, to contemplate. It's not just a matter of asma sughra and kubra. You know, one can't be, if asma is made out of 10 points, what is ahwa, Fadl al-Abbas is 9.89, 9.9, 9.5, and the marja is maybe 9.0, or how does it work? How does it work exactly? You know, some of the Ahl al-Mantaq, the example, they say, as an example, يعني إذا أكو قميص أبيض, so this is the example they give. It doesn't always, remember, مرات المثل يقرب من جهة ويبعد من جهة. In this case, you know, they say like a person, for example, has a white shirt. There are different shades of white, right? The whitest shirt could be that asma kubra, and the other shirts, for example, could be the other various stages of asma. We're not saying that there are no stages when it comes to asma. Yes, the example does make sense, but it's hard to basically project that when it comes to al-Abbas alayhi salam and Fatima al-Ma'suma and Zainab alayhi salam. And with the evidence that we have in hand, inshallah, we will see exactly that, how it's difficult. It's quite difficult for us to put a number. That is why, you know, the Ma'sumin, they have their own thing. And then Sheikh Astanad says, in the da'ira thaniya as well, there are levels. The same way that in the first da'ira, for the Prophet, right? Ali, Fatima, all the way to Sahab al-Amr, there are levels. Same thing with da'ira thaniya, there are levels. And the same thing goes on and on with the Prophets, he says. You know, and he mentions a hadith from the Quran. For example, one example right now. Let's look at one example, and then we'll look at the hadith, and then we'll conclude, inshallah, the majlis. The story of Ukht Musa, alayhi salam. Ukht Musa. Kulthum or Kalthum or Maryam. These are the name. Maryam, she's called Maryam, by the way, in the biblical text. Kulthum or Kalthum in our text. The sister of Musa, alayhi salam, had maqam or al-dawr. Dawr, hifaz, wasi Allah, wa nabi Allah, wa rasool Allah Musa, ibn Imran. Go back to the Quran and read the story of the sister of Moses. That is the maqam of sister of Moses, alayhi salam. She had dawr, hifaz, waliya Allah. She's the one, when they came looking, she's the one who took Musa. She's the one who told him that take Musa to this family. And then she's the one who, through all this, returned Musa back to who? Ila ummi, to his mother. And what do we see now? Zainab alayhi salam had maqam, hufz, waliya Allah, wa imam zamaniha, Ali ibn al-Husayn alayhi salam. She was given the task of protecting Imam al-Zaman Ali ibn al-Husayn. And she was also given the wasiyyah by her brother Husayn ibn Ali to who? To Zainab bil-khafiyyah. Laysa bil-zahir. Or bil-zahir, laysa bil-khafiyyah. I'll look at the hadith later, inshaAllah. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad wa ajil farajahum wa al-ala ajahum.
We'll refer to that hadith at the end, inshallah. It's one of the last hadith that we will discuss, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. These are some of the maqamat of Zainab that makes us question, who really is Zainab? And can we really just refer to it as minor and major asma? No, Zainab has, by the way, my dear brothers and sisters, Zainab alayhi salam has a maqam, a status in the eyes of Allah al-Azim. Wallah al-Azim muqassirin bi maqamiha. And when I say muqassirin, and I mean like us Shia, let's leave the amma, al-khasa muqassirin bi maqamiha. Zainab had a role in Karbala, by the way. Without her, there would be no Hussein and Ashura. Let's look at some of these examples. Other than the one we discussed, right? First of all, her ilm is from Allah. Ya amma, anti bihamdillah alimatun ghayra mu'allam. Right, we said that in the beginning, right? Other evidence that we have, as narrated, for example, in the majlis of Yazid, وَرَأَيْتُ زَيْنَبُ بِنْتِ عَلِيٍ عَلَيْهِ Zainab bint Ali alayhi salam. I witnessed Zainab bint Ali. Listen. وَلَمْ أَرَى خَفِيرَةٌ قَطٌ أَنْتَقُ مِنْهَا كَأَنَّهَا تَفْرِغُ عَنْ لِسَانِ أَمِيرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَمَحَلِّ الشَّاهِدِ قال وقد أومأت إلى الناس أن أسكتوا فارتدت الأنفاس وسكنت الأنفاس وسكتت الأصوات. Zainab عليه السلام, he says, and I have not seen a woman more chaste, more pure, more honorable than Zainab. It is as if Imam Ali is sitting and he is speaking. It's as if the words that are coming out of her mouth are the words of Amir al-Mu'mineen. And as Zainab placed her hand, everyone was loud, yelling and shouting, Zainab placed her hand and everyone quieted down. Everyone went silent. Ali ibn al-Husayn, by the way, same thing with Ali ibn al-Husayn, by the way. Look at what, for Ali ibn al-Husayn, it says, Ihtijaj, Kitab al-Ihtijaj, Sheikh al-Tabrasi reports. Ihtijaj Ali ibn al-Husayn, alayhi salam, ala ahli al-Kufa. Qala Khudaym ibn Shariq al-Asadi, kharaja Zayn al-Abidin, alayhi salam, ila al-Nas, wa awma'a ilayhim an uskutu fasakatu. Here, Ali ibn al-Husayn doing this, the same thing as his aunt Zainab. This maqamat, this wilayat akwiniya, this existential authority that the Imam has, Zainab has a portion of it as well. You see the same action between the two, between Zainab alayhi salam and between who? And between Ali ibn al-Husayn Sajjad alayhi, the Imam of her time. Again, in the khutbah against Yazid, she says, Alhamdulillah alladhi akramana بنبيه محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وطهرنا من الرجس تطهيرا وإنما يفتضح الفاسق ويكذب الفاجر وهو غيرنا والحمد لله. Zainab, this is the words of Zainab. Zainab, by the way, this is the words of Zainab al-Kubra in front of a man who moments, days, just butchered her brother and the head of her brother Hussein, by the way. Now, with all due respect, all of us right now, if our mother or our brother, our brothers, for example, our father, our siblings, their head is raised in front of a spear right in front of us. I'm not saying about courage, or I'm not talking about courage here. Would we be able to even hold ourselves for a moment to give a sermon like Zainab? No. Nobody. Bring me one person. She says, and by the grace of Allah, and Muhammad, who graced us and who purified us through purification. Zainab Tahira. And that is why Sheikh al-Sanad also refers that the Ahlul Bayt is not just the Ma'sumin Arba'at Ashar. They're not just the 14 Ma'sumin. No. The likes of Hamza, Ja'far, Abu Talib, Abdul Muttalib. Why is it that in the wasaya of Rasulullah, in his deathbed, he sees... Sorry, it was in the wasiya of Ali ibn Abi Talib that Zainab alayhi salam reports, by the way. He says... كأني أرى جدي كأني أرى رسول الله وحمزة وجعفر. مضمون الحديث. Imam Ali عليه السلام in his final moments says, I see the angels, I see رسول الله, and he says, and I see حمزة and جعفر. And then he ends. And all the other احتجاجات on the day of Ashura, refer to the books of Maqatil. أبي عبد الله عليه السلام on the day of Ashura, he has a piece of poetry, أبيات من الشعر وفيه يحتج على القوم منا أسد الله حمزة ومنا جعفر الطيار ذو الجناحين. And from us is the lion حمزة, and from us is جعفر الطيار. And that's why Sheikh al-Sanad says that the Ahlul Bayt is not as small as you think it is. No, Ahlul Bayt is a much wider circle. No, it's one circle and it's a circle that encompasses the secondary circle. Then of course we have the hadith of Hakima. The hadith of Hakima in which we hear about the wasiyah of Hussein to Zainab alayhi salam. Quickly, it says, now I only have it here in Arabic, I'm going to try to translate it as I read. I entered upon Hakima, the daughter of Muhammad ibn Ali al-Ridha, peace be upon him, year 262 after Hijrah. And I spoke to her from behind the veil. وَسَأَلْتُهَا عَنْ دِينَ And I asked her about her faith. And she began, فَسَمَّتْ لِي She began to tell me by name who she تَأْتَمُّ بِمَاذَا بِهِمْ تَأْتَمُّ بِهِمْ She began to say, Hakima alayhi salam began to tell them, okay, for this imam, that imam, that imam, قَالَتْ فُلَانِ ابْنُ الْحَسَنِ فَسَمَّتْهُ فَقُلْتُ لَهَا The narrator says, فَقُلْتُ لَهَا And I said to her, جَعَلِنِ اللَّهُ فِدَاك May I be ransomed, may I be sacrificed for you. هذا الخبر يعني هذا الخبر right now you just told me this religion of yours the imams he says هل هي عن معاينة أو خبر you witnessed this or is it a خبر that's been narrated to you by the imams themselves قالت خبر عن أبي محمد أبو محمد عليه السلام referred to me this خبر كتب به إلى أمه قلت لها So he says that Abu Muhammad wrote to his mother and he said to her that this is the deen, this is the names of the imams to the mother. So now here, then of course she says, then when al-mawlud, then he said masturun bil-ghayba, right? Then where is the son? Then she says, as in Imam al-Mahdi, he said, well, he is hidden, he's in occultation. Now here, he says, ila man tafza'u al-shia. Pay attention. And where do the Shia go when they need to seek help? Remember the time that after Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam, al-Hadi, al-Askari, al-Ruba, basically, yeah, Muhammad Jawad and onwards mostly, the Shia faced a very hard times. And they couldn't go to the Imam. Who did they go to? إِلَى الْجَدَّ أُمَّ أَبِي مُحَمَّدٍ عليه السلام. The mother of Abu Muhammad al-Askari عليه السلام. They would go to her in seeking matters of faith, in seeking matters of religion. Now he said, he wants, the narrator wants proof of this matter. Why is it that this is happening? Like who is he emulating? بِمَنْ يَقْتَدِي قَالْ أَقْتَدِي بِمَنْ وَصَيَّتُهُ إِلَىٰ إِمْرَأَةٍ. Now we're not sure, by the way. يعني كلامه هذا من يعني كلام مستغرب كلام مثلا يعني we can't tell. Is he depending on the situation? Is he saying it? Okay. Well, who is it? Who is he emulating that he takes it from a woman? Or is it actually genuine? Or who is he emulating? I want to know. She said, اقتدي بالحسين بن علي عليه السلام أوصى إلى أخته زينب بنت علي في الظاهر وكان ما يخرج من علي بن الحسين عليهم السلام من علم ينسب إلى زينب سترا. زينب عليه السلام كانت هي الوصول بين الحسين عليه السلام بين علي بن الحسين عليه السلام وزينب هي الذي كانت من يفزع إليها الشيعة. So Zainab, as Hussein gave the wasiyah to Zainab, and then from there on, Zainab became that anything came from Zainab, it would come from Ali ibn Hussein, but Zainab alayhi salam would be the one to who? To orate and give the ahkam. Zainab, during those short years that Zainab alayhi salam lived. Even before that, by the way, our hadith tells us that the Imam gave Ali ibn Hussein the wasiyah even before that. And there are many more shawahid, by the way. Zainab alayhi salam in Kufa teaching the woman about tafsir al-Quran. For example, the hadith of Kaf Ha Ya Ain Sad. And Zainab was there teaching the woman of Kufa tafsir al-Quran. And her dad comes in, so on and so forth. Zainab alayhi salam, who when abiha, latif on hadha al-hadith, by the way. Hadith latif jiddan. The hadith says that... After this, inshallah, we will end with the masiba of Zainab. يعني صدق حديث من هذا الحديث من زينب عليه السلام من أجمل الأحاديث. وبصراحة بس كلمة هاي الكلمة من زينب عليه السلام نستطيع أن نتفرع ونتفرع ونتفرع. This hadith that I'm going to share with you right now, this one hadith we can take it and we can begin to extract from it entire discussions and discourse. يوم من الأيام وزينب مع أبيها أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام. Zainab was her father, Imam Ali عليه السلام. And then she says to her father, يا أبتا أتحبنا. He says to her father, Oh father, do you love us? And then she says to him, Yes, I love you. بكل فوادي. أنتم ريحانتي أنتم كذا كذا. I love you with everything, my daughter Zainab. Then Zainab says to her father, يا أبتا لا تقول أحب. قول كون شفيقا. الشفقة. She says to him. She says to him, Oh father, don't say I love, for their only love is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But شفقة أنت تشفق علينا. Right? You're compassionate towards us. Because love is for Allah only. Meaning what? Meaning everything that you do for Allah, even when you love in this world somebody, is always for Allah and you hate for Allah. الحب لله والبغض لله. From this hadith alone, Zainab alayhi salam has given us the qa'ida of al-hubb lillah wal-bughd lillah. And she says, keep this word love between you and Allah, and then be compassionate towards each other. Everything else follows. That's Zainab alayhi salam. Zainab al-mu'allama, Zainab al-fahima, Zainab. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا زَيْنَبْ يَرْوِي يَحْيَى الْمَزَانِي قَال نختم. كنت في جوار أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام في المدينة مدة طويلة وبالقرب من البيت الذي تسكنه زينب ابنته عليها السلام فلا والله ما رأيت لها شخصا ولا سمعت لها صوتا. And by Allah, I did not hear a crackle of voice from Zainab, nor did I ever see her existence ever during my time living in Medina. And you know where I'm going. وكانت إذ أرادت الخروج لزيارة جدها رسول الله تخرج ليلا والحسن عن يمينها والحسين عن شمالها وأمير المؤمنين أمامها. And when she would leave during the nights to visit her grandfather رسول الله, Hussein would be on her right, Hassan on his left, أمير المؤمنين in front of her. فإذا قربت من القبر الشريف سبقها أمير المؤمنين فأخمد ضوء القناديل فسأله الحسن مرة عن ذلك. So when they would go to the Rasulullah's grave, and Hassan and Hussein and Imam Ali alayhi salam, the Imam would tell his children, turn off the lamps. Ukhmudul Niran. Al-Hassan one day asked his father, he said, لِمَاذَا فَقَالْ أَخْشَى أَنْ يُنْظَرَ أَحَدٌ إِلَىٰ شَخْصِ أُخْتِكَ زَيْنَبِ. يَا أَهْلَ الْعَالَمْ هَذِهِ أُمَّ الْمَصَائِبْ هَذِهِ زَيْنَبَ الْكُبْرَى هذه زينب الذي ورثت مصائب أمها روحي لها الفداء. يا أخوان ويا أخوات, هذه زينب التي قرأوا شخصها يوم عاشوراء. هذه زينب التي وقفت أمام الناس والرجال الأجانب ينظرون إلى شخصها. هذه الزينب التي قد ضربت من الأعداء. هذا الحديث أرويه واعتذر من صاحب الأمر. يقول يروون أهل السير وأهل الأخبار, وأروي لكم مضمون الحديث من القلب, أروي لكم مضمون الحديث. يقول أن يوما من الأيام كان المختار جالسا وأتى شخص من الأعداء الذي كان قد شارك في كربلاء, شارك بدم الحسين عليه السلام, شارك بسبي النساء الطاهرات بنات النبي. قال له يا مختار, أنا قد فعلت شيئا يوم عاشوراء. قال له قل لي ماذا فعلت. قال الأمان, أريد الأمان, إذا أعطيتني الأمان فأقول. قال لا أمان لك وعليك لعنة الله. قال لا أمان لي. قال لا أمان لك. قال اسمع اسمع لكي يحترق قلبك. خل احرق قلبك أنا يا مختار, يا صاحب الزمان, عذرا يا صاحب الزمان. قال أنا كنت الشخص الذي قد أرسله عمر بن سعد لسبي النساء وضرب النساء وحرق الخيام, كما حرقوا باب دار السهراء حرقوا بيوت النبي. نعم, ما جرى على الحسين مرآة كما جرى على الزهراء. نعم, ضربوا الزهراء, أدموا الزهراء, قتلوا المحسن. نعم, ضربوا بنات النبي في يوم عاشوراء وحرقوا الخيام. يقول: وأنا أضرب النساء، أضرب الأطفال، طفلان بنتان ركضتا إلى امرأة طويلة القامة، امرأة طويلة مرة طويلة، ولاذت بها وأخذت بعباتها وقامت تحمي عن الأطفال. وأتيت المرأة وقلت لها: يا أمة الله، يا مرأة، اتركي الأطفال. قالت: لا. قال: اتركي الأطفال. قالت: لا. قامت تحمي عن الأطفال. صورت الموضع، الأبهات والأمهات صوروا الموضع. قالت: أخذت بالعباة تحمي الأطفال، وقال له: يا مختار، أخذت الصوت وضربتها مرة وثانية وثالثة على أم رأسي حتى أسقطت. ضربتها 3 مرات حتى أسقطت على الأرض. ويقولون: لماذا تشحق فاطمة؟ لأن فاطمة ترى ابنتها زينب على رمضاء كربلاء وهي تسقط على الأرض. وأختم بهذا الخبر عن زينب أم المصائب. يقول المؤرخون، يروون بأن يوم عاشوراء أيضا هذا الشخص هم أتى للمختار، هم قام يقول له: يا مختار، فعلت كذا وكذا. وقال له: يا مختار، في يوم عاشوراء نظرت وزي والحسين عليه السلام على رمضياء كربلاء يجود بنفسه وينزف الدم، ينزف من الدم، يتقلب أبا عبد الله يمينا وشمالا على رمضاء كربلاء. قال: ورأيت عنده زينب الكبرى. جئت إلى الحسين وزينب تبكي وتلطم، وأردت أن أحرق قلب زينب. يا الله يا الله، صاعد الله قلبك يا صاحب العرس. أردت أن أحرق قلب زينب، فأتيت الحسين عليه السلام ونزعت القميص من الحسين. فقال له المختار: لماذا فعلت ذلك؟ لماذا نزعت القميص؟ قال: والله إني لا أرغب في القميص ولا أريد هذا القميص، ما أريد هذا القميص، لا أرغب به ولا أريد، إنما أردت نزع هذا القميص لكي يحترق قلب زينب عليه السلام. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. سلام الله عليك يا مولاتي يا زينب الكبرى، وعظم الله لكم الأجر.